All right, this week, living in Lexington, we're going to be talking about carpenter bees and how to know that you have them. Take a look at the top of our hot tub. You can see the wood particles, and you'll see the holes. We're going to post some pictures, but we can show you right here where they've started on our treated lumber with making holes. Well, they actually make holes inside the wood, and they'll make more than one. They'll actually make a tube and lay their eggs and stuff in there. They're a black and yellow bee. We're gonna post a picture of it inside the video so you can see them. We've tried a couple things. We tried some borax, which is just a laundry detergent that we've mixed with water. That worked temporarily, but more bees came back and they're still doing holes. So the other thing we found on the internet is making a fake hornet's nest. And so my friend Trey told me about this, and they've got one on their porch, and they've not had any trouble since. He said you do need to move it each year if you see more problems. So what you do is you're going to take a brown bag, not a giant grocery bag. You're going to need, you know, a small bag. You're going to crinkle it up so that it's like resembles a hornet's nest is what we're going for, because other bees are scared of the hornets, or at least these carpenter bees are, because they'll attack them and kill them. So they'll see this hornet's nest and won't come around. That's the idea. So what we did is I watched a couple videos, did a little research. You want to crinkle your bag up, make sure the bottom's crinkled up, and then you're going to need some weight so that it's not so flimsy it just blows around and doesn't seem real. So for us here in South Carolina, we have sand instead of, you know, we don't have as a lot of rocks, so we have sand. So I took my idea was to take a plastic bag, put some sand in it, and that's what I'm putting in the bottom, so possibly no moisture can get on the bag. So we're going to put that in there. I got just a couple pieces of paper to crinkle up. And then you make your little nest type thing here at the top. So what I'm using is I have a bread tie. We're going to use this bread tie like such. Tighten that up. And then we're going to put a screw up here. So we're gonna hang our hornet's nest off of this. So stay tuned. We'll do a follow-up in the comments. I'll do a little follow-up, let everybody know how this worked for us. And I may even make a second one and put on the other side of the building here. But that's, from what we read, is this fake hornet's nest is going to make those carpenter bees and all those problems go away. Thanks, everyone. Just another tip from living in Lexington. Bye.